फ्रेंड्स, वेरी गुड इवनिंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून. दिस इज कल्प शाह फ्रॉम कल्प शाह सीए क्लासेस एंड अग्रवाल कंसल्टेंट्स फ्रॉम अहमदाबाद, गुजरात, इंडिया. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू अप्लाई इंटरनेशनल ट्रेडमार्क एज पर मैड्रिड सिस्टम. मैड्रिड सिस्टम ट्रेडमार्क इज वैलिड इन मैनी कंट्रीज. वी शुड फर्स्ट गूगल अप्लाई मैड्रिड सिस्टम ट्रेडमार्क. फर्स्ट यू विल गेट टू एड्स दैट यू नीड टू इग्नोर. देन यू नीड टू कम ऑन दिस वेबसाइट मैड्रिड www.vpo.int Madrid. On the same website, you will get this page. Here you get the Madrid system is currently a convenient and cost-effective solution for registering and managing trademarks worldwide. And you will get valid trademark for almost 122 countries. Who can use the Madrid system? First question. For using a Madrid system, you should be located, or your business should be located in one of the 122 countries. If you want to know which are the countries, then you need to click on this 122 countries and then right click and open in a new tab. Then you will get some information. We will see which are the countries. That's not a problem for us. Here the Madrid Union currently has 106 members covering 122 countries. These members represent more than 80% of worldwide with the potential for expansion as growth. Here you need to click here and then you can find the countries. 122 countries are included in Madrid protocol for trademark purpose. Protocol relating to Madrid agreement concerning the international registration of marks. This is the base document according to which all the countries are accepting this trademark, including China, India, and many more. You can find the list over here. United States of America, India, and China. Three major countries are included. That means the whole world is included. Let's see the procedural part. How much cost? Then you can go here over here for getting the FAQs relating to Madrid system. How can I contact the Madrid registry? These are the call center numbers for Madrid registry. This is their code. I think it's for Geneva. Online you can also call. Questions on international register extracts. Which form should I use to apply for international registration of my mark? That is MM2 form you need to download and then file. All international applications based on national and regional applications or registration should be filed using MM2 form. International forms MM1 and 3 are no longer applicable for Madrid website. All international applications designating the United States of America must also include form MM18. If you are from United States of America, then you should also include one another form, that is MM18. Note, if international application is filed using MM1 or 3 on or after 2015 October, the application will be considered irregular. That means MM1 and MM3 are no longer valid. That's it. Simple. MM2 is applicable. How can I send VPO the forms required for international registration of a mark? Forms can be sent by mail, through a postal or any other delivery service, or through contact Madrid. Forms may also send through a Madrid portfolio manager. Over here you can find a Madrid portfolio manager. Or else you can find this Madrid contact us. You need to create user ID password, that we will see in a while how to create user ID password for this Madrid. Contract Madrid is another link where you can get context or you can solve your questions. I am a trademark holder, representative or any other interested party from a national or regional IP office. My quest concerns relating a form submission. Here you need to upload a form. These are the country included in Madrid system. The next question is here you can get find my contact Madrid, Madrid registry contact details, which we have already seen. How can I calculate international application fees and make a payment to VPO? Payment how to do payment, how to file application. They have already information about international application fees, including calculation of fees and payment method is available under how to file application. So we can find over here. The fees payable in connection with an application for international registration purpose, the basic fee, the complementary fee for each contracting party designated, and the supplementary for fees for each class of goods and services. There are three types of fees: basic fee, complementary, and supplementary fee. And if you are having more than three class of service or goods, then you need to also pay supplementary fees. For certain contracting parties, the complementary fees is replaced by an individual fee. To confirm whether or not a contracting party applies the individual fee, check the list of individual fees. You can find here checklist of individual fees. Then here the schedule of fees. In India, for each class of goods or services, individual fees will be applicable. Designations made in international application or subsequent in international registration. The following fees are payable in place of complementary fees when the contracting parties mentioned below are designated under the protocol. If you are from India, I am from India, as mentioned earlier, I need to pay this much fee as a individual fee instead of complementary, 124. This is the simple fees calculation which we have seen. How can I check the status of my international application or request a change concerning the international registration? You can check the status on Madrid monitor tool that we can find after creating user ID password. Just in a while I am showing you how to create user ID and password. How can I check the status of my international registration that we have seen over here, Madrid monitor? Then how can I renew my international registration? How can I transfer my international registration to someone else? What is the limit of an office of a designated contracting party to issue a provisional refusal of protection? How can I restrict? These are little less important questions. And these are some Brexit related questions. We are not discussing that at now. Here we need to click on the contact Madrid. Here is a Madrid website and you can contact Madrid. Here we need to open one new account in WIPO, create an account. I am showing you how to create it. Just a while. These are the Madrid schedule of fees. Swiss francs, it is mentioned in Swiss francs. You can convert into dollars or whatever rupees it is. International application, the following fees shall be applicable and shall cover 10 years. 10 years applicability validity will be there. Basic fee, where no reproduction of the mark is in color. If there is no color, 653. If it is in color, 903. Supplementary fee for each class of goods and services beyond three classes, except if any contracting parties in respect of which individual fees are payable. If we have mentioned already, checked that Indian individual fees. If you are paying individual fees, then there is no need to pay supplementary fees. Complementary fees for each designated contracting party, except if the designated contracting party is a contracting party in respect of which an individual fees 2.4 below is payable. Individual fee for each designated contracting party in respect of which an individual fee rather than a complementary fee is payable, except where the designated contracting party and contracting party of the office of the origin are both states bound by the agreement. That's not important that much, but this is the fee you get. These are the fee schedule. You can find it over here, total in Swiss franc. Over here you can log in or you can open a new WIPO account. Click here. Then you need to enter a username and password. I am creating an account as a simple procedure. So over here I have filled all the information like basic information, email ID, etc., name, address, country, password, etc. And then you can need to create an account. What is it called? VPO accounts are personal and not generic. Please provide your personal details. Invalid username. Then I can create kalpshah.2000 Gmail. I drop it. Just Gmail's first things I am keeping. I need to again this enter the captcha backpacked. VPO has been account has been created and requires validation. Confirmation link has been sent to your email ID. Please check the spam filters if you don't receive email in your inbox or request resend. From here you can request the resend. I am checking it. Here is my validation mail. Please visit the following link in order to confirm your VPO account. So I have clicked over there. The creation of VPO account has been successful. Now I need to enter user ID and password. Here I am logging. This is directly showing me the renewal option. E-renewal is available as of 3 months before the renewal date of international registration. It is also available during the grace period subject to a surcharge. But I don't have any IRN number, international registration number. So I am just applying for new registration. Over here you can find some good information. Over here you can find different options, patents, then marks, then designs. In marks, Madrid application assistant, Madrid goods and service manager. We are concerned with Madrid because we are applying for trademark. Then you need to go Madrid manager is over there. Madrid goods and services, Madrid's profiles, database, Madrid fees calculator. If you click on the fees calculator, you can find how much fees you are going to pay for your trademark. Please select which transaction you wish to estimate the cost of. New application. Date. Your office of origin. Then you need to select your country. My country is in India. Number of classes covered by the mark. In how many classes you want to apply. One or two. Is your mark collective mark? Is your mark in colors? If it is in color, that they are going to take some more fees. Please select the contracting parties. You need to select your contracting parties. If your office of origin is not listed, it is not a member of the Madrid Union. Therefore, the international protection of your mark can only be obtained by applying for its registration with industrial property office of each country or region in which you seek. If your country is not in a Madrid treaty or Madrid protocol, then you need to contact your local industrial office, property office. That means your local IP intellectual property office. My contracting party should be in India. Where is it? Let me find it. These are the countries available: Afghanistan, Cuba, Cyprus, Algeria, Ireland. I am finding Italy, Iceland, Japan, Kenya. Where is India? Let me select it. This wants to say that in which countries you want to make your trademark applicable. If you want to select all countries, then you can select over here, select all. That means in all of the above countries, your trademark application will be valid. Because these all the countries are partners of this Madrid system. And your country of origin, you have already mentioned. That means India is part and parcel of this treaty. So here India name is not mentioned because you are from Indian origin and you are contracting with this remaining countries. If I select any other countries, this will not appear in the below list. If say for example I select over here United States of America, then United States will not appear over here. See, in U there is no United States of America, but if I select India, then it will allow me to select United States of America. Here it is, US United States of America. That means you are from India and your trademark will be valid in all those countries which you select over here. So this is selection, and I calculate my fees. It will be basic fee 903, fees for contracting parties 27997, total grand total CHF Swiss franc. This is my calculation. In this fashion I calculate my international trademark fees. Because I chose color, so they took some more fees. If I deselect, then they may reduce the fees. Let me select it, calculate. Yes, still it's same, because I have chosen all the countries, all the contracting parties. I want to make my trademark applicable. In none of the countries anyone can use my trademark. I will be the only person who will be the owner of the trademark of in this mentioned countries in the list: Portugal, Switzerland, Czech Republic, Finland, Ghana, Hungary, Indonesia, almost 207 countries. Okay, here you can find many options like Madrid file, Madrid application assistant, Madrid Goods and Services Manager. If I click on Madrid Application Assistant, they will guide me to redirect to this link, discover the Madrid Application Assistant. Simple process, faster completion, validated data. Then I can click over here, get started. I need to select my country of origin, India. Visit the Madrid member profile database. Information about your office of origin, online filing date, then they should redirect me to the Indian trademark office, but that I don't need now. I need to apply in MM2, which I mentioned earlier. Over here you can download the Madrid forms. Madrid 1 and 3 is not valid nowadays. Instruction for the completion of editable PDF forms. You can find the instruction over here. These are the instruction you can find in Adobe Reader. You can file the forms. And this is the MM2 form which we are waiting for. You need to click over here in PDF. It will open any PDF format. If you want to download, then go back, then click edit PDF option. Then you need to save it in your computer. I am saving it. So here is my friends Madrid 2 form in front of my eyes. Madrid protocol concerning the international registration of marks, important. This form must be used to file international application under the Madrid protocol. The form must be sent to the office of origin. It must not be sent directly to the international bureau. You should send it to the office of origin. The cover page must not be sent to the international bureau. Madrid systems contacts, mailing address, you need to send over here, Switzerland, or you can submit online, or you can inquire over here for this questions, there's submission related queries, form submission, you can select over here. If you submit, then they will redirect to you to this link wherein you can upload your form, and you can click on your form, then upload. But for that, you need to file the form, then upload. You need to fill the form. First, information is for use by the applicant. The international applicant includes the following number of continuation sheets. Officer's reference, MM-17 form, contracting party whose office of origin. Office is the office of origin. Then I need to select over here India. Then applicant, I need to enter my name. Kalp Shah GST classes. Then I need to enter my address. Fill address for correspondence. You can copy over here if it is same. Ahmedabad, Gujarat, India. Then you need to enter your phone number in the international format. Fax I don't have. Very old system of fax they are talking about. Email ID, so simple. Then you need to choose the language, French, Spanish, if you know it. Other indications as may be required by certain designation contracting parties, such as, for example, the United States of America, only provide indication in either form. If the applicant is a natural person, nationality of the applicant. This is required for USA. If the applicant is legal entity, please provide both the following indications. Legal nature of the entity, like company, like HUF, in India, or partnership firm, state, country, state, and where applicable, territorial unit within that state, canton, province, state, etc., under the law of which state legal entity has been organized. That means under which state, say for example, my company is company, state is Gujarat, then I need to enter the data. And Companies Act, under which law I am registered, Companies Act 2013, for example. And entitlement to file, check the appropriate box where the contracting party mentioned in item 1 is a state. The applicant is a national of that state. Where the contracting party mentioned in the item 1 is an organization, the name of the state of the of which the applicant is a national. If you are a national, that means if you are a citizen of that state of India, then you need to select over here. And if you are not of that nation's citizen, that is the country, if you are from other country, then you need to mention that country, USA. So either you can be this or this, not both at the same time. The applicant is domiciled in the territory of the contracting party mentioned in item 1. Contracting party is India, because my business organization is located in India and I am also citizen of India, then I need to choose one. But if my organization is located in India, but I am a citizen of USA, then I need to choose two and write over here USA. The applicant has a real and effective industrial or commercial establishment in the territory of the contracting party mentioned in item 1. Or I can have a company in India. I am a USA citizen, but I am not... I am a citizen of USA and I have a business in India, and that business is company, then I can select that. But I am selecting that. Where the address of the applicant given in 2B is not in the territory of contracting party mentioned in item 1, indicate the space provided below. If you are from USA, then you need to mention the address of yours over here. If the box in para At present item has been checked, the domicile of the applicant and the territory of the contracting party. If the box in Vera, that's okay. Appointment of a representative, you need to write the name of the representative. I myself is the representative of my company, so no need to mention someone else's name. My address. My mobile number, my email ID, basic application or basic registration application, basic application number, date of basic application, basic registration number you need to mention over here. Then you need to upload the you need to copy or paste your photograph or trademark over it. Please place the reproduction of the mark as it appears in the basic application or basic registration in the square below. Where the reproduction is in black and white and color is claimed in item number 8, place a color reproduction of the mark. If you are applying for color, then you need to put over here also. The applicant declares that he wishes the mark to be considered as marks in standard characters. The mark consists exclusively of a color or combination of colors such as without any figurative element. Then you need to select over there if it is in color but no figurative element. Colors claimed, then you need to mention the colors which you have claimed. As it is in iPhone color white or something like that, Vodafone red color. The applicant claims color as a distinctive feature of the mark. Color combination or colors claimed. You need to select this, then you need to mention the colors over there. Indication of each color of the principal parts of the mark that are in that color. Then transliteration of the mark. Then you need to translate in English what is the meaning. This information is compulsory where the mark consists of contains matter in characters other than Latin characters or numerals other than Arabic or Roman numerals. If you are entering any mark which is not in English, that is not in Latin, or any numbers in which is not in Roman or Arabic, then you need to enter over here. There you need to transliteration. That means you need to enter what is the meaning in English. Mention there. Translation of the mark as may be required by certain designated contracting parties. Do not check the box in item C if you provide a translation in this item. If you are selecting over here, then select C. This words, the words contained in the mark have no meaning and therefore cannot be translated. Do not check this box if you have provided translated. If you have already provided translation, then you cannot mention that there is no meaning. There is a meaning. But if you are saying there is no meaning, then you cannot say, give meaning over here in B. Where applicable, check the relevant box or boxes below. Three-dimensional mark, sound mark, collective mark, certification mark, whatever it is, you need to choose that. Description of the mark as may be required by certain designated contracting parties, such as, for example, the United States of America. Description, you need to describe your marks. Description of mark contained in the basic application or basic registration, while applicable, only use the item if the office of origin requires you to include this description in the international application for the purposes of the item. Apart from this form, you can find some information PDF file which consists of 15 pages in which each and every section of this form MM2 has been explained. Say for example, item 1, contracting party whose office is the office of origin. The office of origin is the office of the contracting party through which the applicant derives entitlement to file the international application. It is the office in which the basic application will have been filed or the basic registration will be recorded. That means my office of origin in India, because I am located in India, I am citizen of India. The name of the state whose office is the office of origin should be given in item 1, for example, China. If the office of origin is the office of intergovernmental organization, which is the European Union, then the indication European Union should be given. If there is more than one applicant, in the name of the only one contracting party should be indicated as the contracting party whose office is the office of origin. Each and every item is mentioned over here. We are in the ninth item. Let's go to the ninth item. Item 9. Yes, 9A. Miscellaneous indications. The base and crux is 7th number and 8th number, which is your mark which you are claiming. Priority claim. The applicant claims the priority of the earlier filing mentioned below. Office of earlier filing, name of earlier filing available. What is the meaning of this? You can find is over here in 6th number. This is 7th number, the mark. You can, if you want to take the help, then you can take over here. What is that? This open in a new tab. Not a problem. This is 7 number, this is help file. I must open 7 number help file if I want to take help regarding that. This is long file. You need to understand what is mark. An applicant is required to provide a reproduction of the mark for which international registration is being sought. And this is the subject matter of item 7 of the form. The reproduction should be two-dimensional and graphic or photographic. You need to enter a photograph over there in the 7th number item. It must be identical with the mark as it appears in the basic application or the basic registration. Thus, if the mark in the basic application or the basic registration is in black and white, must the mark be in the international application. Basic application is in your country, your Indian application in my case. Likewise, if the basic mark is in color, so must the mark in the international application. Likewise, you can find the each and every instruction of 7th number over here. Form MM2INF. I will put it in the description box. No worries, friends. I am always like to help people. This is 9 number. We were filing. Description of the mark as may be required by certain designated contracting parties. Verbal elements of the mark, where applicable, the applicant wishes to disclaim protection for the following elements of the mark that you need to enter. Then, goods and services. You can find indications that are pre-accepted by the International Bureau in the Madrid Goods and Service Manager, MGS. By using these indications, you can avoid possible irregularities concerning the classification of goods and services and a delay in the recording of international registration. Please make consistent use of semicolon to clearly specify the goods and services indications in your list. Example, scientific, optical and electronic apparatus and instruments, screens and photographing, computers, advertising applications, that you need to check in this VPO MGS, Madrid Goods and Service Manager, over here in the internet. Where is my account? So many tabs are open. I forgot where I opened my account. This happens when I researching and I open many tabs. I go back, it may come. Here you will find Madrid Application Assistant and Madrid Goods and Services Manager. Madrid Goods and Service Manager. Here it will open. You can also find a tutorial. Click on the help link to watch the tutorial. Say for example, I type computer. This is the number of that item, goods and service item. 9 number, scientific research, navigation, surveying, etc. Then there is 45. If I select 43, they will show me what are the items included in 43, class 43. Services for providing food and drink, temporary accommodation, 20. Then it will show me what are the items included in 20. Cards for computer, computer furniture, this computer tables. Some basic things, that's not a problem. You can add the class and description of goods and services. Then the applicant wishes to limit the list of goods and services in respect of one or more designated contracting parties as follows. Contracting, if you want to apply for only for some countries, then you can select over here. Contracting parties, you can choose over here. India. In this fashion you can do, friends, in this fashion you can file the whole form. 11th is the designation. What is the meaning of designation? Then you can check over here in the 11th number. All that is required to check the box corresponding to the contracting party or parties in which it is intended to seek protection for mark. That means in which countries you want to protect your mark. However, an applicant should pay particular attention to designation of contracting parties like the European Union, USA, Ireland, Singapore, Cuba, Ghana, Japan. Designation of the European Union, that they have explained. Designation of the United States, they have explained. The designation of Ireland, this you need to understand. Signature is the 12th number, 13 is certification, and signature of the by the office of origin. The office of origin must sign and date the international application form and must indicate the date on which it is received the request to present the application to the international bureau. That means first of all you need to apply to the office of origin India, then they need to apply. You need to apply in the international website, that is WIPO. The indication of the date of receipt is important because, as a rule, this will or may become the date of international registration, provided that the international application is received by international bureau within the period of 2 months from its receipt by the office of origin. Items 13 of the application form takes the format of the certification of certain elements by the office of origin. The elements should therefore be verified by the office of origin and are as follows. The date of receipt of the office of origin, identity between the basic marks and the mark that is subject to the international application. You can read over here. Fees calculation is given in the 13th number. Fee calculation sheet. This is 13th is a certification and signature of international application by the office of the origin. You need to type the date, say for example 38th of September 2020. Name of the office. Name and signature of the official signing on behalf of the office. Name and email address of the contact person. That means you need to enter the address of the Indian IP office, trademark office, Indian trademark office, or your country's trademark office. These are the things you need to understand and form the file. Thank you, friends, for seeing this video. If you are looking for any professional help, then you can contact on the below number. 800002850 is my WhatsApp number, and that is international format. It is +91. You need to add +91 before 8. before the number +91 you can enter, and international help you can take. Thank you, friends. And we are providing these services: new company incorporation in India, trademark registration in India, GST registration in India, trademark registration internationally, income tax registration in India, import export code in India, FSI, that is food license in India, food safety license, and every kind of legal services in India, like company incorporation in India, LLP incorporation in India, trademark registration, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, legal drafting, then every kind of legal services we are providing in India. Thank you, friends.